Today we're going to be talking about characteristics of quadratic functions and their graphs. A quadratic function is when you have the your highest exponent is 2. When your largest exponent is 2, then it's a quadratic. And if you graph a quadratic, you're going to be graphing a parabola. And a parabola looks either like an umbrella or like a U. You can have sideways parabolas that are this way and this way, but then they're not functions, so we won't be talking about those. We'll just be talking about the umbrellas and the U's. So all of these are parabolas or quadratic functions. Okay. So what you're going to need to know is where it crosses the y-axis, or the y-intercept, the vertex. The vertex is the lowest point or the highest point. If it's an umbrella, it's going to be the highest point or the maximum. If it's a U, then it's going to be the lowest point or the minimum. If we're talking about the vertex, we need to talk about the x and the y. I know this is kind of just giving you too much information right now, but it'll come together in just a minute. If you're talking about the maximum or the minimum, it's the y, just the y of the vertex. The axis of symmetry is the x of the vertex. So if you know the vertex, then you know basically two things about the parabola. The y of the vertex is the highest or the lowest point, and the axis of symmetry is the x of the vertex. But I need to tell you a little bit more about that in just a second, because I kind of forgot to type that in whenever I was doing this. My dogs are fighting in the living room. I guess he took care of it. Okay, so we're going to be interpreting these graphs, and on your questions, it's only going to ask you one of these questions, but I just put all four of them in one particular picture so we can, you know, kind of cover it all at one time. Okay, y-intercept. This is the y-axis. Where does it cross the y-axis? Right here. And where does it cross the y-axis? At 0. The vertex is at 0, 0. It is right there. And the maximum is at 0, which is this 0. And the axis of symmetry, now I forgot to put this down, it should say equation of axis of symmetry. And because of that, you always have to put x equals. And that is this 0. So that 0 and that 0. Y-intercept, where does it cross the y-axis? At negative 1. The vertex is at negative 2, negative 9. Because I know where the vertex is, I know the maximum is at negative 9. And the equation for the axis of symmetry is x equals negative 2. Always x equals whenever it's the equation for axis of symmetry. And what x equals negative 2 is, it's an imaginary line that goes straight through the parabola and divides it into two identical or symmetrical points. And since it's a line, you have to have an equation. And since you have an equation, it's going to be x equals. And it's going to be x equals because it crosses the x-axis vertically. Y-intercept, it crosses the y-axis at 5. The vertex is at 0, 5. So since it's at 0, 5, the maximum, because it's the highest point, is at 5, and the axis of symmetry is at x equals 0. Y-intercept is at 3, because it's right there. The vertex is right here, which is at negative 3, my eyes are kind of playing tricks on me, negative 6. So we have a minimum because we have a lowest point of negative 6, and axis of symmetry is x equals negative 3.